We want to determine the area bounded by the two functions f of x equals x plus 1 and g of x equals x squared minus 4x plus 5. The first step in this type of problem is to determine the x coordinates of the points of intersection, because we'll use those for the limits of integration. Looking at the graph of our two functions here, notice the x coordinate of the first point of intersection is x equals 1, and the second point of intersection is x equals 4. So we'll set up a definite integral on the interval from 1 to 4. And then the integrand will be the top function minus the bottom function. And the reason this works is, if we determine the area under the top function bounded by the x-axis, or the area of this blue region, and then we subtract out the area under the bottom function, or this region here, you can see we'd be left with this blue region here, which would be the area of the bounded region. Now, if we didn't have a graph, we'd have to set these equations equal to each other and solve for x to determine the limits of integration. And I want to go ahead and show that for this example. To determine the x coordinates of the point of intersections, we'd set x plus 1 equal to x squared minus 4x plus 5. We have a quadratic equation here, so we'll set it equal to 0 and see if we can factor. So we'll subtract x and subtract 1 on both sides. So we'd have 0 equals x squared minus 5x plus 4. So we'd have x minus 4 times x minus 1. So x equals 1 and x equals 4. So this does match with our graph that will integrate on the interval from 1 to 4. Let's go ahead and set up our definite integral. The area of the bounded region is going to be equal to the definite integral from 1 to 4 of the top function, which is x plus 1, minus the bottom function, which is x squared minus 4x plus 5, integrated with respects to x. So we'll have the definite integral from 1 to 4 of, we'll have negative x squared, and then we'll have x minus negative 4x, that's going to be plus 5x. Then we'll have 1 minus 5, so we'll have minus 4. Now we'll determine the antiderivative, so we'll have negative x cubed over 3 plus 5 times x squared over 2, that'll be 5 halves x squared, and then minus 4x. So now we'll substitute 4 for x, and then 1 for x, and then determine the difference. So we'll have negative 4 cubed divided by 3 plus 5 halves times 4 squared minus 4 times 4 minus, replacing x with 1, we'll have negative 1 to the third divided by 3 plus 5 halves times 1 squared minus 4 times 1. So here we'll have negative 64 thirds. Here we're going to have 16 times 5 halves, which will be 40, minus 16, minus the quantity negative 1 third, plus 5 halves, minus 4. And we'll do the rest on the calculator. So this is 8 thirds. This is a negative 11 sixths. So we'll have 8 thirds minus negative 11 sixths. So the area of the bounded region is 4.5 or 4.5. So the area of the bounded region here in blue is 4.5 square units. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.